Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, from the God of King David, who chose Jerusalem to be his eternal capital on this earth, hear the word of the Lord. The word of the Lord is Ayala, Ayala, Ayala. Return to me, O Israel, unto the Beulah land, for the Lord God is calling you to come home, come home, come home immediately to Beulah land, says the Lord God Most High, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. For even as David, the son of Jesse, killed the lion and the bear and the giant, my people Israel, you must defeat the bear now, says the Lord. For out of the north a bear is roaring and coming against my people, my holy people Israel. And I shall destroy the works that have been made, even according to my word. Isaiah 55:17 says the Lord, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. Every tongue that rises up against me, thou shalt condemn. This is the inheritance of the saints of God, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. For before you can defeat the giant, you must first defeat the bear and the lion, says the Lord. And the bear is roaring out of the north at this time. And the giant, I will tell the Gentiles know who I'm talking about. And the Messianic Christians know who I'm talking about. The giant is the Antichrist. That will be the final battle, even as the name Israel will be fulfilled. Even today, Israel is seen in the world by the world as Jacob, a supplanter, supplanting those Palestinians and all those people out of that area. But in the eyes of God, Jacob is not a supplanter, but he is Israel. He who wrestles with God and man and overcomes, O nation of Israel, you've been wrestling with all of the world because you brought forth the seed of the woman, because you brought forth the seed of Abraham that God has raised up forever, a throne. The throne of David has been raised up for eternity, that the Messiah would sit on the throne of David. Hallelujah. That's why man has wrestled with the nation of Israel. And Israel, you have also wrestled with God, with idolatry in the Old Testament, not obeying the commandments, not keeping the Shemitahs, all of those things, and then not receiving your Messiah. But the day comes, says the Lord, even as I'm trying to tell you, says the Lord God Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. In Zechariah, the same text, Zechariah chapter 12, verse 10, it says, in that day, says the Lord, I will pour out a spirit of prayer and supplication on Israel. And you will mourn for the one you pierced as one mourns for an only begotten son. When you see the Messiah coming in all of his glory. And in that same text, listen to me, O Israel. O those of you who need to Ayala, go back to Israel. Go home to the motherland, where God is calling you to Beulah land. In that same chapter of Zechariah, it says that in that day the whole nation will be like David. Let this be a sign unto you that even as David was one man who killed the lion and killed the bear and killed the giant, the whole nation of Israel, the whole tribe of Judah, the whole tribe of Judah, in the land of Beulah, will be like David in the house of David in that day, says the Lord God. Hallelujah. Praise God. So the word from the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, from him who chose Jerusalem, capital on this earth, and chose a man after his own heart, King David, to be the eternal prince over the city of Jerusalem. Hallelujah. God has raised you up, this generation, for such a time as this. For God is about to make you like the house of David. For you surely I will deliver you from the snare of the fowler. Surely I will deliver you from the noisome pestilence, says the Lord God Most High. Those who have set their love upon me, I will show you my salvation, says the Lord. For I am your salvation, says the Lord. God is your salvation. El Yahshua. God is your salvation. Hallelujah. For God himself, even as father Abraham, when he was about to take Isaac up the mountain to sacrifice him, Isaac was carrying his own wood, carrying a cross on his back, some wood, and he said, Father, where is the sacrifice? And Father Abraham said, God will provide himself a sacrifice. Hallelujah. And God provided himself as a sacrifice, O nation of Israel. Hallelujah. Let this be done unto you, even as it is in heaven. Hallelujah. Let it be done unto you, even as you believe. Hallelujah. For the Lord God is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all you can ask or think. And he shall deliver his people Israel. He shall deliver his people Israel out of the snare of the foe. Hallelujah. Let this be a sign and a buzzword amongst your people. Hallelujah. That the Tsar Shalom is with you. Hallelujah. That you would receive him in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. For El Yeshua, God is my salvation. Hallelujah. So listen to me, O nation of Israel. The word of God is spoken clearly to you. Come home. Come home from the four winds of the earth. The Lord is calling you to the north, to the south, and the east, and the west. Come home. Come home, children of Abraham. Come home, children of Isaac. Come home, children of Jacob. Hallelujah. For the God is calling you, even as he's turning in those four corners, in those four directions, from the north, from the south, from the east, and the west. The Lord is calling you, calling you, calling you. Come home. Come home. Come home, come home. The Lord is compelling you to come. Yahweh has spoken to my people in France and said, come home, come home. There's a place prepared for you. God has prepared Hashem, as many Israelites call him, the name. Hashem has prepared a place for you. In Hashem's land there are many dwelling places. Hallelujah. And he's prepared a place for you. Hallelujah. Come home to the natural, earthly, promised land that God has promised to the natural earth seed of Abraham. Come home. Come home. For in his Beulah land, there are many dwelling places. And he's calling you. Come home, O Israel. Wake up, O children of Israel. Hallelujah. Arise from the dead, and God will give you life. Come home, O those of you who are still dry bones. Is let there be life in you, that you would come alive. Come alive, come alive, and come home. Hallelujah. For God is about to set this world at naught by his power. God is about to show this whole world that he is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Hallelujah. That he is the God of Israel, and there is a God in Israel. Hallelujah. God's about to show forth his glory in Beulah land. Hallelujah. In Hesba. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty. Hallelujah, hallelujah, for the bulls of Bashan have compassed about the land of Israel. But the Lord says, it shall not stand, and it shall no. The Lord knows how to deliver those, hallelujah, who love him. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He'll set those plans at naught, says the Lord. All the enemies of Israel be bound in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. For the Lord will bind you and grind you into the dust on the ground, even as the golden bull of Bashan that was made by those rebellious children when Moses was on the mountain. He had them to grind that bull of Bashan into powder and had them to drink it. Thus shall you, those enemies of Israel and those idol worshippers will drink from the cup of bitterness, hallelujah, that God will put in their mouth. It will be woodworm in their mouth, says the Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah. I'll cause those who worship idols to drink of the poison of their spirit. Hallelujah, says the Lord God Almighty. Praise be God Most High. Hallelujah, Creator of heaven and earth. God bless you, my friends. God bless you, all Israeli people. God bless you, Church of the Living God. You born again Gentiles. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. That's another video. Israel to the nation of Israel. The Gentile, true Gentile church is about to depart out of this world. For the Lord will come as a thief in the night and take his people. Now what will be left on earth is all these denominations that are not following the word of God, that are not walking with the Lord. There'll be what many of you think of as Christianity. You think about Rome. That is not biblical Christianity. You shall see with your own eyes, and you'll know those Gentiles who stood with Israel, those righteous Gentiles who supported you, they'll be gone. They'll be gone. They'll be gone. Don't trust in the friendship of the nations. For when the true born-again Gentile Christians are gone, the whole world will come together in unity to destroy God's chosen people, the Israelites, the blood descendants of Israel will become the arch enemies of the new giant, this new Nimrod, this new strong man who will rise and bring a false peace in the land. Wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord, for the Lord is your salvation.